Hey everyone, welcome to Somerville's Twilight Princess Guide, Part 73. Yeah, nice coming music, and then the big horn sounds out of nowhere. Anyway, so yeah, after talking to the creepy old lady, she gives you the little whistle thing, which you're supposed to take back to Ilia. So after you finish talking with her, before heading outside, actually. Well, let's just say you actually will have to head outside first to transform into the wolf, because for some reason, no matter where you transform inside the village, apparently you'll be seen. I don't know exactly how that's possible, but it happens, I guess. So, anyway, you have to go outside to transform into the wolf, and once you do that, go back into the hidden village. There should be a post. But either way, go ahead and head into the back over here. You can actually talk to the chicken. And you see there's all these dick spots, and they have hearts and rubies, you know, if you need them. And of course, for the last house zone, it's supposed to be all difficult. Almost there, not quite. This is the last hellstone for the game. Seems kind of early in a way, just because this is only video 73, and like I said, I already recorded the entire game, and there's like 114 videos total. Castles in the background, which kind of hints that the next house zone is by Hyrule Castle. Jumps off to his death. Nice. Anyway, so yeah, like I said, Hyrule Castle. It is pretty much at the gates of the castle. Yeah, I was just saying that the whistle was there, but apparently it's not. Oh well.
What want
to? So, since you have the,
you can
whistle, you can either teleport over to Kakariko Village, but since we did unlock the final hidden skill, or, well, the location for it, anyway, let's go ahead and do that first, so I can get that out of the way. I don't have to worry about it anymore. And I guess you really don't have to transform back into the human if you don't want to. Or maybe you do just because of those guards. I don't remember if they try to stop you or not, but just in case, I went ahead and transformed back into the human. So just head to the front gate of the castle. And this is where you need to look. Well, then again, you do have to transform into the human anyway. Because of the wolf. Duh. Sorry, it's like 2:10 a.m. right now. And I'm like 4 hours past my bedtime, or the time I usually go to bed now. yeah, well. Anyway. Doing jump strike. Just hold Z and then hold down A until the star charges up, or lights up, whatever. Then let go of A to attack. So there's the great spin, which is pretty much what you've already known with the spin attack. However, this one's more powerful. And of course, the only time the great spin will actually be effective is if all your hearts are completely. As you can see, there's like this red little light or slash, whatever you want to call it. This red whoosh. Well, whoosh isn't really a color sound. It's a red thing that follows the edge of the sword. Anyway, it just creates a more powerful spin attack if your life is full. If not, then you'll just have, of course, the normal spin attack. Okay, so now all the hidden skills are learned. Who learned ya? Yeah. And of course, you see the freaking castle's all surrounded by this force field thing. Anyway, so since you can't go anywhere else, teleport or warp to Kakariko Village and give or show Ilia the whistle.
You
of course, it's not easy to go ahead and transform back into human, back, you know, out in the open since no one's outside. And then she all of a sudden remembers everything. Oh, dirty. I bet he was.